Jesus begins his high priestly prayer by saying, Father, glorify your Son, that your Son may glorify you. I want to encourage you right now. Would you join me? Let's ask the Father to wash us and cleanse us and glorify himself through our lives, just like Jesus prayed Jesus that he could be glorified through our lives. Father God, we want to thank you that you've called us to glory. Father, Paul said, whom you foreknew, you also did predestinate and call and justify and glorify. Father, that includes us right now. We're your children. Father, your purpose is to glorify yourself through our life. That we'd be like stars shining in the heaven through the praise of your glorious grace forever and ever. So, Father God, we break off the shackles of religion. Father God, Paul said to stop laying again the same foundations of repentance from sin, even though we know, Father, this is primary and forever. But that, Father God, you want us to look beyond to see where we're going, that you want to glorify yourself through our lives. So, Father, we pray like your Son. Glorify yourself through our life. Let us shine, Father, like the stars. According to you in the book of Daniel forever and ever. Jesus, you ask the Father to glorify you, and he would be glorified through you. Jesus, we ask you to do the same thing for us. You see, beloved one, you're going to see as we continue in John 17 that Jesus wants us to participate in his glory. Now, don't misunderstand what I'm saying. Beloved one, we're always going to be, Jesus, we repent. We're not doing what we need to be doing to enter into eternal life in a deeper way. Right now, I repent. We repent. Jesus, we want to know you. Jesus, bring us deeper in to the dimension of eternal life. Eternal life. Gift that's ours in you. Notice Jesus says in verse 4, he says to the Father, I glorified you on earth. And then he said, Having accomplished the work which you have given me to do, the point is in this high priestly prayer, Jesus is pouring out his love to the Father. And I want you to hear that Jesus does not separate loving God from working for God. You see, Jesus came to earth because he loved God. And because he loved God, he accomplished the work that the Father gave him to do. This means that if we love God, we have to do the work that he gave us to do. Jesus is going to say later in this